Good morning, Holy Spirit. For such a beautiful day to celebrate. To God be the glory for waking us up this morning with fresh power of God. Thank you, Lord, for what you are doing in our lives and are about to do today. Amen. And in Jesus' name I will pray. Friends, in these tough times and uncertainties brought about by COVID-19 health crisis, it takes the Spirit of God to rebuild lives and sustain lives at will. Zerubbabel was given the responsibility of rebuilding the temple in Jerusalem, Haggai 1 and Ezra 3. As the work was being completed, the returned exiles were indeed weak, harassed by the enemies, tired, discouraged, and poor. But actually, they had God on their side. Therefore, the prophets Haggai and Zechariah gave the moral and spiritual encouragement to resume the work on the temple by declaring, "This is the word of the Lord to Zerubbabel, not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord." Zechariah chapter 4, verse 6. Beloved, many people believe that to survive in this world, a person must be tough, strong, unbending, and harsh. But God says, not by force, nor by strength, but by my spirit. I shall live for God, determined not to trust in your own strength and abilities. Instead, depend on God and work in the power of His Spirit. The work of rebuilding the temple will only be accomplished by God's Spirit, and not by human might, nor power. Just as Zerubbabel will need to depend on the Spirit of the Lord to accomplish the work, so do Christians today. Friends, you and I have no ability in ourselves to shine the light of God, truth, to those walking in darkness. Just like Zerubbabel, this morning God is making a similar promise to those who remain faithful to Him. You need not be discouraged by human limitations or afraid of the current economic and financial obstacles. God is filling you and equipping you with His Spirit to complete what He has begun with you in your life. Beloved, our God-given work is guaranteed to be successful, not by human might or power, but by the guidance an empowering of God's Holy Spirit poured into our lives, like the oil that flowed Zechariah's lampstand. I pray that as you step out today, may the presence of God go with you, that the power of God protect you. The Spirit of the Most High God direct and contend with any demonic provocations by the powers of darkness. Even so, may the resurrection power of God sustain you in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Above all, may the face of God shine upon you as the finger of God fight for you and the wisdom of God guide you and bring you home safely in the name of Jesus Christ, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, and the Alpha and Omega. Stay blessed and have a wonderful day.